What is poppin', everyone? It's Big Bat with another video. Today we're gonna run something pretty crazy. If you've seen my recent videos, you know what this is. Look at this. Yep, our Buccaneer is shooting like a tac shooter. Through the use of mods, we can get this man to shoot like a tac shooter. And one of the issues with this mod is you can't do all three paths. You can't cross path him. You can only do the basic pathing. However, that's fine. What we're going to do is do the utility type path on this man, the one that can pop LEDs and pop camos for that reason. Just because I want to see how that looks and everything. Then we'll try the top path, and then we're going to show you something pretty crazy you guys are going to be a little shook by, I think. So we're going to get our farm up, and if you've been wondering where I've been this week, I've actually been pretty sick. And it's been pretty hard to record just because I've been on very low energy. My throat's been pretty rough and whatnot. It affects my voice and all that. But I'm pretty much out of it at this point. The one thing that does suck is I do have work tonight and I'm gonna have it this weekend. So it's gonna be a little hard to upload, but we're gonna try. We're gonna try and upload as much as we can. And next week, I'm going to grind. Next week will be a grind and this channel will go off. So anyways, as you see, just by the fact that this man is shooting like a tac shooter, he's doing really well on his own. The Monkey Buccaneer is one of my favorite towers. Usually he is my favorite. It kind of changes every once in a while, but I'd say, you know, consistently he's probably the most favorite. Unless you count monkey farms, because then I guess those would be, but... Alright, let's do Grape Shot because things are starting to get past a little. Now look at how this looks. See, oh, there's camo. Let's do the camo detection. So it's pretty nice because Grapeshot usually shoots 5, and this man is shooting, I believe, 30. Because it shooting like a tac shooter doesn't just make it, you know, spread out like a tac shooter would. It actually does the 6 times the amount of. Oh no, let's do the fire one. Of 6 times the amount of projectiles, just like a tac shooter does. And so he's going off. It makes him very powerful. Let's go with the cannon ship because you know, that's gonna look cool and it's also very powerful. So he's shooting out 6 bombs with it, so that's really, really nice. And of course, with the double shot, that will increase much more, but we can't really do that with this man. So we're gonna have him here for the LEDs and the camos, but let's put a Buccaneer in front of him so that we can check out the double shots. Let's do faster shooting and the double shot. Let's just see that first. So it looks like the double shot doesn't affect his normal shooting too much. Maybe it's a little faster than it would be. But let's do the grape shot, and I think it should affect that. I don't know, what do you guys think? Do you think it's more? Look, that looks pretty trippy. Just looking into him too much, like, looks a little mesmerizing. But what we're going to do after this is we're going to make a Paragon. And if you're wondering if it affects the Paragon, it does. And I think it might make the strongest version of this Paragon, you know, other than like using a mod to get it past Paragon level 100, or, you know, a mod to Ultra Boost it or something. Which, if you guys know of a mod like that, let me know, because I do want to end up trying that out. I want to see what, like, 1,000 Paragon level Buccaneer and other Paragons look like. That'd be really cool, especially with the Sentry Engineer coming out. Or I get the Engineer Paragon, whatever. So this man's going off. These guys are really powerful on their own. Let's do the Destroyer. Look at that. If you look directly into the Destroyer, it's literally like hypnotizing. Okay, let's just keep on increasing this farm, because we're gonna need a lot of money for our Paragon. Now, the crazy... I tested out the Paragon before this, and in terms of popping bads, I'm not so sure if it makes it too much better. However, it literally pulls in every Moab so fast. It's ridiculous. You guys are going to be shook. Alright, so far so good. Let's do Monkey Pirates and Pirate Lord. Why not? Let's sell this so we can see how the Pirate Lord does. So pretty good. pretty good. Not insanely impressive, but pretty good. I like it. It's pretty cool. Now let's put this man back down and let's see the destroyer with the hot shot, and let's do the aircraft carrier. So the aircraft carrier looks pretty strong. I don't know if it makes him better, because maybe I'm wrong, maybe my memory's just messed up, but this man only has one airplane. That's less than normal. Like, they usually have more, don't they? So let's do carrier flagship. There we go. There's still just one plane, and this man cannot detect camo, but let's give him camo detection at this point. What are we doing? There we go. Camo detection. Let's do the radius and the jungle drums as well. So I have a feeling that the airplane from the aircraft carrier is not as strong as it would be. So it might even be a nerf to the top path buccaneer a little bit, but I think it's a buff to the pirate lord buccaneer. However, either way though, I'm pretty sure it's a buff to the paragon. And if these aren't buffs, then at least it's a different way to play it, I guess. And it's pretty good in my opinion. But you'll see. The paragon is pretty nuts. Of course, you know, paragons are of course nuts, but you guys are going to be probably a little shook. I know I was definitely shook. There we go. Yep, so far so good. And we're getting very close to being able to put down a paragon. We're very, very close. So let's put down our next buccaneer so we can get the upgrade. There we go, let's do the bottom path. We have enough now. Let's do Navark of the Seas, let's do it. All right. See, so this man actually shoots out like a tack shooter. And you see how fast he's pulling in all those things? Yeah, so he's shooting like a tack shooter. So that's pretty cool, it's pretty nice. Let's make him degree 100. So that we can actually go to a higher round. Let's do round 200 real quick. Here we go. So let's just see how he handles the bats. Look, that looks pretty nuts. That looks pretty crazy. The thing is I'd have to see if this is better than the regular Paragon, because the regular Paragon has no real trouble against bats anyway. Look at that. Look, do you see that? Look at that. Look how fast he's pulling in all the Moabs. Look at that. They're just directly going to him. There's no Moabs are getting past whatsoever. None. Okay, you guys, tell me this is not nuts. Tell me it's not nuts. Look at that. And now maybe my memory's wrong and maybe he can do that. I don't think he does it this fast. Not at all. And I think the reason for this is because, like I told you before, he's doing things pretty much 6 times at once. So he's able to pull in Moabs 6 times faster than a regular Paragon. That's what I think. Maybe I'm wrong. Maybe this whole video's wrong. Let me know in the comments if I'm wrong. But look at how nuts this is. And it's crazy because he's also making money because he's pulling them in. And he's actually making it, like, not crazy fast, but much faster than you would expect somebody who has nothing to do with money to do. Oh my god, I'm telling you guys, modding makes this game a million times better. Oh my gosh, this is nuts. There's no Moabs. All the Moabs are just literally instantly going into this man. They're not getting far whatsoever. They're doing nothing to us. So let's go to round 300. Because I'm pretty sure round 300 has a DDT rush in it. So let's see if he can take on the DDT rush. Especially one that's sped up. Yeah, he is! That DDT rush did nothing! It did nothing! Look at this, you guys. I don't know. This is pretty ridiculous. Now, like I said, it looks like he's letting bads get past him a little bit. which is not good. So I think, yeah, of course that's his weakness. That's pretty much everything's weakness in this game, to be honest. But this is, I'm pretty sure this is the strongest Paragon. Okay, let's go. It's about to, okay, there we go. That's like the strongest Paragon, and we could place multiple of them. Let's place another one just to see, like, you know, just to do it. Why not, right? Let's do another Paragon. Here we go. So we got all five upgrades, or all three upgrades up, so that allows us to make another Paragon right here. So let's make it degree 100. And if you guys like this video, let me know if you want to do another one. I know that it affects the Ninja Paragon. I haven't tried the other ones, but I'm assuming if it affects the Buccaneer and the Ninja, that it'll affect the other Paragons. And we actually need more money, and I did not think about that. So let's see if they can survive. We are just pulling in so many Moabs, it's ridiculous. I wish there was some kind of count on just Moab deaths, because these guys are nuts. They just one-shot everything. There's nothing, there's no Moabs that can get past. Actually, you know what I'm gonna do? You know what I'm gonna do? Let's try out something crazy right now. Let's try out something crazy. Hold on. Okay. Sandbox mode. I'm going to do the biggest DDT rush ever. And I'm gonna see if he can handle it perfectly. So let's get a Paragon up. And of course, you're not able to do this normally. It's mainly just through mods, you know, as usual. Everything I do is mostly because of mods. All right, Navark of the Seas. Let's make him degree 100. Here we go, 100. And let's do 999. Let's set it to round 500, so they're crazy. And let's make them fortified. Let's see what he does. Look! It does nothing! You know what this means, you guys? This means that this Paragon is literally invincible other than bats. Only bats can beat this. Nothing else can beat this. Holy crap, you guys. Look at his pop count. It's just going up by a few million a second. Okay, let's get rid of the balloons. Let's make it round. Let's do 999. I think that's the highest we can go. You guys. He's literally doing it pretty much infinitely. There's no amount of Moabs he cannot just instantly defeat. This man's invincible. He's literally invincible. Other than bats. Look at his pop counts going up by over 10 million a second. This is the actually the most nuts tower I've ever seen. I think this is actually the most nuts tower I've ever seen. Let's just do it with like the ZOMGs. Yeah, no effect. They have no effect. That actually means that he can beat every single Moab class balloon there is, other than bad. He's actually invincible. They can't get past at all. There's nothing they can do. Maybe those are just slow. Let's do the regular Moabs. Nope. Even the regular Moabs instantly get destroyed. And if you guys want, like, you want to see how fast these things go? That's how fast they go. This is how fast they're going, and he's popping all of them. Hey, but you know what is nice, though? I just realized. So I have a mod that the more that a tower pops, the more its Paragon level goes up. And when I sold that, I was like, wait a minute. Did I just see what I thought I saw? You guys are going to be shook. It's going to make him better and better. Watch this. So we have 999. Let's do the DDTs. Watch. I wonder if it makes his Paragon level go up. Look at how fast his Paragon level is going up. You guys, I think I found a way to test out a high level Paragon. I think I found out a way. Well, I guess a high level Paragon that shoots like a tax shooter, because this isn't the regular Paragon. But look, degree almost 300 so far. Almost 300. This is nuts, you guys. This is so nuts. I did not expect this thing to be as crazy as it is. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to send to degree 1000, and let's just see how he handles, like, the high-level bad. Why not? Let's just see how crazy that makes it. He defeated him! That was 999! Okay, let's do it again. We're just going to feed this man. Let's do ZMGs at the same time. Can he take on both at once? This man's taking on 999 ZOMGs, 999 ZDTs. They're all fortified, and they're all from round 999. This is nuts, you guys. This is ridiculously nuts. I wonder how much money he's made. Oh, it doesn't tell us. He is literally getting... look at this! Well, I guess it's sped up. He's almost getting a billion pops a second! Okay, you guys. This is actually the... almost 2,000? You guys, I'm not even gonna lie. I didn't know he was this strong. I literally did not know that he was this strong. This is so crazy. Oh my god. Okay, so it's almost done. They're almost defeated. Oh my god. See, this is... And if anyone wants to know what my favorite upgrade or my favorite tower... Like, I had someone in the comments ask what my favorite tower is. Buccaneer and Sniper and stuff, those are pretty much my favorite towers. But favorite upgrade is definitely the Buccaneer Paragon. This man is so crazy. So what we're going to do now, let's take off the 999 count. Let's just do one and see if he can handle one 999 bat. I don't think he can because he'll probably zoom past them immediately. Okay, so he can't. He can't. That's okay. That's okay. Let's see if he can handle an Elite Lunarius. Okay, this is gonna cause my game to crash, I think. You guys, I think he might have actually just destroyed it, like, pretty much instantly. But I forgot it's still on round... let's do it on the actual Elite Lunarius round, which is 120, I believe. So let's do the Elite Lunarius and see if he can destroy it. Oh, here we go. There's a chance there's a second one and that it's just invisible because of, like, the game acting crazy. Okay, it seems like he can't just because... Look at this. It seems like he can't just because of the fact that the Moab spread to further than his ranges. But, this dude's nuts. 58 billion pops. But you saw that when he was attacking the Elite Lunarius, he was literally destroying it instantly. Like, that thing actually released, fortified bads pretty much immediately. So, that definitely means he would have beat it immediately. So, he definitely can't instantly defeat that thing. Let's do round 300, see how he does. Because these have some high-level bads. Round 300 is a killer for most things. Look, he's literally... He's so powerful that he's literally, like, breaking the game. Things are literally getting stuck in place. He's actually breaking the game. Oh my god, you guys. Okay, I'm definitely gonna try out the other Paragons. You don't even have to ask. I'm gonna do it. So look out for those videos. I'm gonna go now. But until next time, guys, I'll see you later. Bye!